Well, welcome everybody as we come together to honour Frank. I know you're all family, so we can be really informal and relaxed as best we possibly can. And whilst we're doing that and thinking why we're here, whom we're here for, and turning off mobile phones, I always say, we're going to listen to a very special piece of music. So we come together this afternoon to mourn the loss of a significant person, Frank Chester Smith, whom passed away suddenly but peacefully on Sunday, the 30th of July, 2017. Almost to his 88th birthday, He was born, as you know, right in the middle of the flood time, I suppose, and that was, Launceston was always famous for the floods in 1929, and Frank was born on the 28th of October. And right at the outset, we acknowledge that Greg and Barbara, Glennis and Peter will be spiritually connected to us at this time, and they're probably together somewhere in Queensland. If not, they will be later on today. So we think of them as well, even though they're not here present with us physically. So we come together, as I said, to mourn the loss of a significant person, to comfort and support each other, and to give Frank just a dignified and honourable farewell as we lay to rest his mortal body and transfer him from his earthly presence here to his final resting place. And just when I said, you know, Frank passed away peacefully but suddenly, I was thinking that was probably how he wanted to go, without being a burden to anybody. And that's something that we can celebrate. And to commence the celebration today, Rose is going to read for us the beautiful Psalm, Psalm 23. And as we go through and listen to Rose reading it, think of Frank's life, the various aspects of his life, the challenges of life. And as you said about the floods in Balaclava Street, how the floods are up near the top of the ceiling. This will all be in the psalm. And I don't know Frank's faith, but I know that to go through some of the challenges of life, and he was so successful in his life that he probably held strongly to the words in this psalm. Thanks, Rose.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters, and he restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Thanks so much, Rose. Because you know Frank and you've known him your whole life, I just wanted to share with you the words that the family wrote. And as we said, Frank did pass away suddenly on Sunday at home, 56 Leslie Street. And he'd been unwell for the past week or so. His father was a blacksmith in Invermay, and Frank married Mary Ellen, and they lived together happily most of the time for more than 65 years. Frank went to Invermay Primary School, and you won't believe, we're going to talk about this a little bit later, but the Invermay Primary School are going to give you a beautiful box of chocolate, two boxes, I think Rose said, especially, it's got a special message attached to it. And I think Frank got into trouble once. He got into trouble for ringing the bell. It must have been the bell that was rung and the people used to race off and get there to school on time. And back in those early days, I guess you probably got into trouble for being a bit late to school. Frank and Mary, these are some of the special memories the family have mentioned, and which we can celebrate today and know that Frank's had a good life. That Frank and Mary went to the theatre every week, usually on a Friday or a Saturday. Sometimes I reckon they'd probably go both nights. And when I saw the photos of Frank and Mary, they were beautiful photos of contented people with beautiful smiles. As we said, they lived in Balaclava Street, had two houses. These would be the Smiths, I guess, 13 and 18. And in the 1929 floods, number 13 still had the watermarks and may have to this day. That's why it was so appropriate. We read Psalm 23 and it talked about the waters. The horse and cart used to park at the end of the street. And Frank, in his working life, he had many jobs, but mainly he worked at Dean's Bakery, Teague's in Brisbane Street, where he served others And then MBL. Wouldn't he have been wonderful? Because I've been in there to Teagues a couple of times in the 70s, and you went in and Frank would have given you a big smile, especially on a day like this early in the morning when Brisbane Street was really busy. And sometimes people need a bit of a pickup, and Frank would have picked up their spirits. He served others, and then he went to the MBL, which I think is it the meat place, the meatworks, a bit further up the road. He had a lot to do with Juventus Soccer Club and was the first probably Australian, fully fledged Australian member into the Juventus Club, and also the secretary. And that has been a very successful club now for a long, long time, and many people have received much joy from the Juventus Soccer Club and the Social Club. And Frank loved to tell lots of stories. He was nearly blind in recent times and often listened to the football, Britain's Got Talent and the ABC radio. But I guess you were his life, his family, son Warren and daughter Karen, Bridget, James and Samantha, and maybe Auntie Helen, you had a part to play too. And surely I know that Greg, he held a special place in Frank's heart. And as Greg says here, he just wanted to share his memories of Frank as a kind elder brother. Frank told his mother one day that it was time that Greg had a proper haircut. So he took him off to Teagues, where the barber gave him his first professional haircut. I wonder, was it one of those when they used to, you sort of like put a pot on your head and went right around the top? I don't know whether it was or not. That's how they used to do it in the olden days. When Greg and another boy stole a comic from Teagues and a sheriff's badge from Coles, Frank hauled him home to Mum. The worst punishment was seeing the comic and badge on the mantelpiece for years after. My word, what a special memory for Greg to have. Frank and Mary often took Glenys and Greg to the Launceston show and other places they normally wouldn't have been able to get to. Frank also loved fishing and took Greg along. He remembers being in a little caravan at Blackman's Lagoon. In recent times, since Greg's retirement, we have had the privilege of spending more time with him, and we will miss our times together so much. Rest now with your beloved Mary. They are beautiful words, and thank you so much to Greg and the family for sharing those special memories. And just whilst you just reflect on your Frank and remember how kind he's been to all of you, we're going to play another very special piece of music.
Say for certain, maybe you're still here. I feel you all around me, your memory so clear. Deep in the stillness, I can hear you speak. You're still an inspiration. Can it be that you are my forever love, and you are watching over me from up above? Fly me up to where you are beyond a distant star. Sleeping here inside my dream, and faith believing, all power can't be seen. As my heart holds you, just one beat away, I cherish all you gave me every day.
There's so much to be thankful for. And as it looks like Frank and Mary are looking down on you now from up there, and that's how it's going to be. So we give thanks. We give thanks for an amazing man, Frank Chester Smith. And we thank God for him, and we thank God for how he was created by God and the gifts that he was given to share with you, his family, with the wider community, and with his many, many friends. And today we pray for you. We pray for you, his family, and we ask God to really bring you peace. And when you think of the name, Dad, Granddad, Frank, you will have warmth in your heart and remember some wonderful, wonderful times that you have shared with Frank and with Mary. And we pray especially today for those up in Rockhampton. We pray that the Lord will bring to them much peace and great memories of having a relationship with a wonderful, wonderful, warm and caring man. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. And maybe we could say together the Lord's Prayer that's printed in the order of service. I'm just checking which version, because yesterday I said the Catholic version. I made a bit of a mistake at the end, because as a Catholic we didn't say the last two lines when I was a young boy. But the prayer that Jesus taught us to pray, and I know that Frank has prayed this prayer many, many times, and I just love, I always emphasize to the people, I love the little part where it says, forgive us those that trespass against us. Because if we all did that, it would make the world a much, much better and more peaceful place. So together we just say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. And just as I say a final committal prayer, we say our final earthly goodbye to Frank. Frank, who's been such an integral part and a meaningful and real foundation of our lives. so tenderly and reverently. We commit the body of our loved one, our Frank, who, as the newspaper said today, he's been the beloved husband of Mary, he's the loved and loving father of Karen and Warren, father-in-law of Bridget, pop to James and Samantha, and the dearly loved brother and brother-in-law of Mari, June and Billy, Greg and Barbara, Glennis and Peter. He's now reunited with Mary. We give thanks for you, Frank. We give thanks for always being there, always being a secure part and a foundation of our life. A man who has sacrificed much by sometimes going off to work in difficult times for our family. We thank you, mate, for always being a great Australian man. And we thank God in particular for giving you such incredible health most of your life. We thank you. We thank you in Jesus' name for being the best you could be. Amen. And especially for Greg and Barbara, I just say this little bit that I mentioned at the start about the chocolates. And I know that according to today's newspaper, Frank used to spend Wednesdays with Greg. So today, we share these chocolates because they came from a movie called Tuesdays with Maury. But we're going to replace that with Wednesdays with Frank, because Greg did enjoy those special days. And this is what came from the movie, Tuesdays with Maury. It said, and this is probably, we're just saying thank you to Frank. It says, as long as we love each other and remember the feeling of love we had, Frank can die without ever really going away. All the love Frank created is still there. All Frank's memories are still there. They live on in the hearts of everyone that Frank has touched and nurtured whilst he was here. That's our final farewell to Frank. And we just leave with one little sentence, something that I often explain, but I learnt many years ago. And this were the words to a man when he finished his service. And I'm beginning to understand it more each day, that life is so short. Be swift to love, just like Frank and Mary did. And make haste to be kind, just like Frank and Mary did. We thank you. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. And just as we finish this service and leave this chapel, we're going to listen to one of the really, really great songs of the last century, Bridge Over Troubled Water. We've talked a lot about water today, but Frank did overcome many challenges in his life by meeting them head on. And this song could have been written about Frank Smith.
Troubled.
When you're right.